Friends. Friends, good afternoon. I'm Kirby Lawrence Hill. I serve as pastor here for the next 2 weeks. Many of you know that I'm about to retire. When I first was considering coming here as pastor, among the many things that I was very excited about was the tremendous music program that is sponsored by this church, a part of which is the Music at Abingdon music series year in and year out. This is part of the expression of that. And I'm so glad to be able to welcome you this afternoon for the last time as I am serving in this capacity. I've greatly been enriched by the music of Music at Abingdon. And I'm thankful for this program today, the memorial concert. I am sad for the occasion, though, that I am the one greeting you rather than John Sal. Many of you may know that John's mother died this past Wednesday, and he is in Nebraska with family, as he should be. We are thankful for John's tremendous work as conductor of the orchestra and director of the oratorio choir, both of which will be presented this afternoon. I'm also very thankful for Eric Meyer, who serves here as organist, who has stepped in John's absence, and will be leading the program this afternoon. I do ask that you keep the Sal family in your prayers in the coming days. I want you to know that this memorial concert tradition stretches back more than six decades. We'll include a prayer and the reading of member names during the Haydn Mass. There's additional honorific and memorial notes that are included in the printed program as well. If you need child care, it is available for free in room 110 through this door and down the hall. There's a restroom right through this door, or additional restrooms through this door and down the hall. There is a reception to greet the artists following in Parish Hall, again through this door. If you need to take the elevator, it is right to your left, go down one level, and down the hall to the parish hall. Music at Abingdon's free format is made possible by generous patrons and those who can offer free will donations. Thank you for all who support this programming. Ushers will receive donations at the intermission for those who wish to contribute. And if you've ever had employees that you wanted to give the pink slip to, you have a pink slip this afternoon. You won't get to fire anybody, but you will get to express what fires you up about coming to these programs. So I will encourage you to fill this out and put it in the offering plates at intermission. That will help in the publicity efforts for Music at Abingdon. This is a sacred tradition in a concert format. We'll welcome the performers and show appreciation with applause following an invocation. I invite you to join with me in prayer. Gracious Creator God, this is an afternoon where we see abundant evidence of your life-giving artistry as flowers and bushes and trees show forth beauty of this spring day. This is an afternoon where we hear abundant evidence of your generous gift-giving to composers, instrumentalists, and vocalists as they show forth the beauty of music you have inspired. This is an afternoon where we remember beautiful hearts of loved ones we have lost in this past year. We ask that this concert challenge the ugliness of the experience of grief challenge it with music lovingly performed, but primarily challenge it with resurrection hope with you as its source, O God. Thank you for the power of this moment and the power of your presence. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
ago, right before COVID, I was supposed to perform it. So it's been, I've had a lot of time to practice. I hope I do all right. But I would really like to dedicate this performance to John and his family. We all know what he's going through, or most of us do, I'm sure. And it's something, it's a rite of passage for all of us, but it's significant.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Please join me in prayer. We thank you, O God, for music played that soothes troubled hearts. We thank you for words sung that affirm life beyond this life. Bring comfort and healing this day to those caught in the grips of grief. We give thanks for the lives of loved ones lost in this past year. With gratitude for the ways they enriched our lives, and with gratitude for resurrection hope, we remember Barbara Benson, Reverend John E. Burgess, Arlene G. Hackman, Herbert L. Harris, Anna M. Hager, Eric W. Johnson, Christine Kim, Carolyn G. McDermott, Audrey Ralph, Diana Sal, C. Todd Smith, Rudolph W. Stroh, Jr., Irma Yerkes, O God, we give thanks that we can affirm that they are whole and well in your loving embrace now and forevermore. Fill us with cherished memories and your steadfast love as we honor their memory this day. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.